This is Porsche RenSport Reunion 5 at Mazda Raceway Laguna Seca. Next race of the day, the Eiffel Trophy Race, Group 3 cars. They should now be on pre-grid. Cars in Race Group 3 to the pre-grid now, please. Starting on the pole for this one is Fritz Seidel in car number 61 from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. 67 Porsche 911S alongside him on that front row, 158 Thomas Gruber from Punta Gorda, Florida, and a 71 Porsche 914-6.
Inside row 2 is Alan Turpin, Sao Paulo, Brazil. He's in a 68 911 TR. Outside row 2 is car number 68, Patrick Long, in a 1968 911 TR. That's Jezebel, Rusty Bond's old car, out of the Dave McNeil stable. Jürgen Barth is up in next in car number 58. It's a 1970 Porsche 911 ST. He's followed by car 910. That's Carl Tolfomeri out of Manhattan Beach in a 1967 911.
Inside the fifth row, starting ninth, car number 90, Gilbert Hakim. Carmel Valley, California, 67 Porsche 911, a 71 Porsche 914 completes the row. That's driven by Trevor Frank of San Jose, car 29.
Visiting us from Banbury, England is Auto Farm's Josh Sadler. He's driving car number 72, a 1970 911 ST. He is inside row 6. Now, what we get with a 914 6s, of course, is a perfectly balanced car, mid-engine Porsche. Those cars tend to be very, very roadable. They tend to work a little better in the twisties, all depending on power and weight. Seidel's car obviously has a lot of horsepower. We saw this morning that he had torque and horsepower to pull up the hill on the main straight and up the hill on the back of the course. Gruber's car looks to be a very good handling car. Turpin's car in the third spot is, again, kind of a horsepower car. And then Patrick Long in the 68 car in Jezebel, that's a handling car. That's a legit 2-liter motor. Smaller motor than a lot of the cars in this competition, but Patrick can drive the wheels off that little car.
Big field in excess of 40 cars. Pace car leading them down through turn 10 now very, very slowly, hoping to get that grid to pack up. Pace car is in at the exit of turn 10. Here comes your front row. Fritz Seidel, Thomas Gruber, looking for the green flag as they make the left turn onto the front straight.
Okay, we'll call the start. We have the green is out now. Here we expect to see Seidel and Turpin's outpower Gruber as they go down into turn one. Gruber got the jump on him. So Thomas Gruber takes the 914-6 to the point. He is followed by Fritz Seidel in the red number 61, Alan Turpin's. And Pat Long has stuck the nose of the 68 inside. Turpin's can't make it stick. Pat Long's wiggling that car hard, so he had it right on the edge of adhesion as they went through the Andretti curve, the button hook, as they head down through the infield.
Seidel locked up a front left wheel on braking in the Andretti hairpin, and he tried to get alongside Gruber as they came out of that corner. Couldn't do it, had to tuck in behind.
Okay, so Pat Long has moved past Turpin's in the infield. And as they head up the hill, this is where Turpin's has more horsepower. It's going to be hard for Patrick to hold the position. He's taking a little bit of a defensive line on the inside. Gruber, meanwhile, is marching up the hill and right now has the measure of Fritz Seidel. And Patrick has held his position against Turpin's as they head to the top to come down the course group.
Yeah, Seidel has definitely closed on Gruber as they got through turn two and now down through the course group. He's trying to get right on the back of that 914-6 driven by Gruber, 158. Seidel driving car number 61. Turpin's rather long in 68, right behind him now up in third spot. Turpin's drops to fourth in the car 4-0. Leaders coming down into turn 11, pretty much nose to tail, and here comes Long. He's looking too. Again, wheel lockup on Seidel. He did the same thing down the Andretti hairpin last time. Here they come up the front straightaway. It's a drag race. As they head up to the Andretti hairpin, they come over the line, and it is Gruber by about a half a car length over Seidel, and Long sitting back and watching him. Let's see what happens when they get to the Andretti hairpin. Seidel looks inside, can't do it. Gruber moves over and shuts the door. Again, a little smoke from that left front wheel on Seidel, 61, but it's Gruber, the leader, as they go to the infield in car 58.
Based on what we know about the motors, I went down into the paddock to check on the 68 car because it was running so well. making sure that that car was a dead stock 2-liter, and it is. We got two cars spinning on field. Car number 5 took a spin. That's Leon Desdemoni in the 19.
Car 5 is Don Ahern. The other car, I believe, was car 4-8. May have been Dave McNeil. It's 5-8 black, excuse me. That would be Jürgen Barth. No change at the top as they go to the top of the hill.
Now, based on what we saw this morning, Dick, it's kind of surprising to see Thomas Gruber be able to hold off what looked like the higher horsepower, higher torque car that Fritz Idel is running. Similarly, Alan Turpins has a little more motor than Patrick Long has. Patrick making up for it with guile and experience, you could say, right now. But the handling cars, the 914 6GT and the 68 2-liter 911, the handling cars right now are putting themselves very well.
Long in the 68 car is shadowing Seidel. He's going to try and make a move on Seidel and move up in the second spot before this is all over. Watch him as they come up the front straightaway. As Gruber is starting to break away a little bit from the rest of the field with that 914-6, car number 58. Seidel's still second in 61, but Long is closing in the 68 car. You can watch him as they go down into the Andretti hairpin again. Seidel locks up that left front wheel under braking going into the Andretti hairpin. Turpin's running fourth in car 40, rather, and Reichel in car 92 is your fifth place car. Gruber's starting to pull it out.
Okay, once again, we're having a problem with the left front fender headlight on Fritz Idel's car starting to come off. We had that happen in a practice session, and that light is now displaced and starting to swing a little free. That may be a problem for the stewards.
Long and Turpin's having a pretty good battle, too. That's the battle. There goes Turpin's trying to make a move on the inside, going up the hill, not going to be able to pull it off. But he wants to let Long know he's there as they go through turn 5 and start up the hill.
Now, Turpin's has got his tires totally warmed up now, and he's feeling much more secure on the track. He's got a little bit of motor over Patrick, and I'd be surprised if Patrick could hold him off for the whole race. It'll be fun to watch.
We're getting reports from the turn workers, the same issue that you've mentioned about the headlight coming loose, left front headlight on Seidel's car. It came loose in practice, it was either yesterday or today, and he got a mechanical blackout. They had to come in. They actually removed the light and then sent him back out. But it looks like the same thing is happening again. Top four cars have pulled away from the rest of the field. Gruber, Seidel, Long, and Turpin, 158, 61, 68, and 40. And they're starting to pull away from the rest of the field. Still Gruber out front in that 914-6, followed by Seidel in 61, and Long, 68, Turpin's 40.
Here we got a good race going on back in the field. We've got Ranson Webster and Hurley Haywood mixing it up. Hurley Haywood is in Alan Benjamin's 54, 67, 911S. First S to ever win an FIA race.
Well, Turpin's up the hill on Long. He made the pass and stuck Long behind some slower cars as they went through there. Now they're heading up in the six. Long is right on the tail of Turpin. The Turpin's in car 40 has reclaimed third spot. Got a standing yellow up at the top of the hill. Okay, so the problem up at turn 6 evidently is car number 97. That would be Larson. It's gone to a waving yellow situation up there. Safety car is going to come out double standing yellow. Safety car will come out. We do have a car through the kitty litter all the way up into the wall. That's car number 97 that we talked about. That's Larson in that car.
Yeah, that's the Hans Niederreiter Racing Porsche, a longtime SCCA IMSA race car that Andrew Larson is now shepherding. It looks like he had a problem on the back end. They were looking under the back of the car and in the engine compartment.
So let's reset it for you. It is still Gruber leading in 58, the 914-6. Seidel in car 61 running in second spot. Third spot is Colin Turpins in car 40. Patrick Long in 68 running in the fourth spot. And car number 92, Reichel, running in the fifth position. That's Michael Reichel in a 67 Porsche 911. Pace car leads them through the infield. A 914-6, followed by one, two, three, four, looks like five 911s. Then another 914-6 behind that.
Reports that car number, I believe it's 29 orange, will be a pull tow at the end of the session.
Looks like the lights are, no, the lights are still blinking on top of the pace car. We'll have to wait and see if they can go green this next time by.
Field coming down through the corkscrew now. Nine seven on the tow are now down in turn eight. When the field goes by, they'll release 9-7 and let him go back to the back paddock. Pace car is going to stay out. I can see the lights still blinking as they come on through turn 11. So we'll have at least one more lap being led by the pace car. Double standing yellow. No one can pass or improve their position. So it's Gruber in 158 or 58. Seidel in 61. Turpins in 40. Long in 68. And Reichel in 92.
We have another stoppage on track. Car number 36, and that's Mike. That's Matt Goetzinger in the red 65 911 has had a mechanical and has stopped on course.
That looks like it's going uphill up in up to the turn six area. You know, the cars behind weren't sure what to do, so they kind of stacked up behind him. Now they're driving around him. Looks like 9-7 is going to require a pull tow. They were hoping to bring him up to the top of the hill and turn him loose, let him coast down the hill, but evidently that's not going to happen, and he is going to require a tow. So this is going to delay it a little more until we can get that car picked up and out of there. He's up at the top of the hill now. Car 30 now comes to a halt. That's John Machul in the 66 Porsche 911, the blue car. Now he's moving again. He was on his way up the hill, too, up by the Ray Hall Strait, heading up to the corkscrew. Pace car leads the field by one more time. The light's still flashing on the pace car, so at least this lap and hopefully not more under the yellow before we go back to a green flag as they're trying to pick up, I believe that was the number 97 car of Larson, who's up there at the top of the hill. Looks like the tow truck crew has worked its magic, and they've got the front end of car number 97 up in the air. Hopefully they can pull him out of the way. And here comes Larson down the hill now, behind the tow truck. The emergency vehicle is going to follow him down through the corkscrew. Pace car leading the field now down through the corkscrew. They're following the tow truck and emergency vehicle with car number 97.
And we got a side view of the driver's side of car 97. Doesn't look like Andrew did any real serious damage to that car, so the Larson crew and family will be happy.
One more lap before we go green. There was speculation they could go green this time, but now we're getting the indication there'll be one more lap as they're passing the tow truck and Larson's car down in going into turn 10. Pace car is going to stay out, looks like. We'll watch them as they head toward turn 11. Lights are still flashing on the pace car, so that means one
more lap under yellow. Let's reset the field for you again. Gruber, your leader in 158. Seidel, car 61, running second, followed by Turpins in 40, Long in 68, and Reichel in 92. That's the top five. Barth in 58, sixth. Desimone, 421, is seventh. Hakim, eighth in car 90. Stoffelmeyer, ninth in car 910. And Sadler, 10th in car number 72.
Our top four cars are blanketed in under a second difference, which is why they've been running quite very much together this whole race. When the race restarts, it'll be an issue of whether Thomas Gruber's 914.6 can hold off what this morning was a slightly superior speed of car 61, Fritz Sadel's 67.911. And then, of course, we got the Alan Turpin's car, car number 40, looks to have a little bit of horsepower, a little bit of grunt over Pat Long's car number 68, the 2-liter 911. The 2-liter probably has a handling advantage. So we got different dynamics on those first four cars. Two cars battling for the lead, two cars battling for the third spot.
Prescott, I think it's going to come down to reaction time. If Gruber sees that green flag and sticks his foot to the floor before anybody else can, he's going to be gone in just that quicker reaction. And he's got the advantage because he is the lead car. He is setting the pace when they come around that final corner. And he goes, it's going to be tough for Seidel and Turpins and Long to react as quickly as he can. So I would guess that he's going to get a little bit of a jump at the start. And he's going to need that going down into the Andretti hairpin.
Yeah, exactly. If you're Gruber, you're looking to anticipate the green flag, try to get going a couple of seconds earlier, get a jump before you actually see the green. Very seldom get a wave off in this situation. So it is a good move. Okay, they're coming down.
Yeah, you don't want to get going before you see the green. Remember Texas starts?
I haven't heard
one of those in a long time.
Yeah,
that's over-anticipating the green.
Now, you got to be very careful, but you'd like to get a little bitty jump if you could here, because a wave off is very unusual on a restart.
Gruber slows him down.
He's accelerating, and we got a green. We're going.
Here he comes, and Seidel trying to stay with him. Going to tuck in behind him as they crest the hill and go down into the Andretti hairpin. I would expect Seidel to try and dive inside, and Gruber's going to keep it tight inside and will not allow him to do it. Seidel goes outside, tries to take the traffic line, and Turpins dives inside of Seidel, trying to take second spot as they're down in the Andretti hairpin. Seidel a little bit sideways on the X of the corner. Turpins and Seidel side by side going into three, and Turpins has to drop back to third, and this is allowing Gruber to pull out a little bit in that 914.6. Gruber out front, Seidel in pursuit, and 61 with Turpins all over the back of his car, number 40. And here comes Patrick Long in 68. Those are the top four that you talked about that had relatively identical lap times.
Okay, Alan Turpin sees an opportunity with Fritz Seidel, obviously, which we wouldn't have guessed from this morning's times. A good fight for second place between Turpins and Seidel will help Patrick Long close up a little bit on that duo. Be fun to watch. Up the hill.
Coming down the hill now, it is still Gruber being pursued by Seidel, being pursued by Turpins, being pursued by Long. The jockey for position coming into the final corner down here, turn 11.
And they're a little spaced out right now. Nobody really close enough to kind of be able to make a move going down into Andretti, although Turpins has certainly looked to close up on Seidel. Gruber takes a wide line for a late apex. That keeps him marching. Seidel had to do a little bit of a middle of the track move to try to protect against Turpins diving on him, but they're spaced out a little bit now. We've got about two car lengths between Gruber and Seidel and about four car lengths back to Turpins.
Good battle at the head of this field with a 914.6. Leading 3 9-11s, and Patrick Long has dropped way back off the pace. Not sure what happened to him, but Turpins is really keeping Seidel honest. And Long has dropped back a little. He's in fourth spot now in the 68 car, but Turpins in 40 all over Seidel in 61. And I guess this is allowing Gruber, your race leader, to break away a little bit because Seidel has to drive a little defensively to make sure that Turpin stays behind him and is breaking his concentration and trying to catch the race leader.
Patrick has definitely checked back just a little against the pace he was holding this morning. He's now turning a 145.7. Still got a slightly faster time than Turpin's, but has fallen back in the race. And the front runners are on the pit straight right now, and they're pretty well spaced out. We've got three or four or five car lengths between each one of them.
Gruber, your race leader, has turned the fastest lap in the race, a 144.851. Seidel still in second spot, and he closed it up again. He locks up, looks like the left front wheel under heavy braking down into the Andretti hairpin. This allows Turpins to close back up on him again in that number 49.11. So the top three cars just equally apart, and then it's quite a ways gap to Patrick Long in 68, who has dropped considerably off the pace. He was right in the thick of it. It was a four-car battle as they were going through that set of turns on the restart, but Long, for some reason, has slowed his pace a little and has dropped back in the 68 car. Reichel still running fifth in 92.
Turpin's looking inside Seidel going up the hill. Couldn't make it stick. Couldn't make the pass. Moved out, but didn't have the grunt to get there.
He looked inside, and Turpin's looked inside him at the same time.
Yeah, Seidel just gave a hand gesture back to Alan Turpins. It was a wave, nothing obscene.
Around through turn 11 and up the front straightaway.
Seidel
trying to make a move here as they come on up, tucks in behind Gruber as they go by start finish. They're going to have at least two more laps as the clock is running down on this. I would expect a one lap sign next time by. Seidel looks inside, going down into the Andretti hairpin. Can't get it done as Gruber moves over and closes the door.
Boy, that was close.
It really was. He almost had his nose in there, and Gruber came right across and filled that gap. No place for Seidel to go. He had a tap to brake and tuck in behind.
Okay, this was on now. This is going to come down to who makes the first misstep. Somebody locks up their brakes. Somebody gets a little loose.
Yeah, traffic could play a part in this if they encounter some, but it looks clear going up the hill as they exit turn 5 and start to climb up to the corkscrew. Turpin's getting anxious. He wants to make a move on Seidel in car number 40, hopes that he can catch him off guard because Seidel is concentrating on overtaking Gruber, the leader. Hopefully, Turpin thinks he can make a move on Seidel and catch him unawares. They're up at the corkscrew starting their descent now. I'll keep my eye on the starter. I would expect to see the one-lap sign when they come across the start-finish line this time by. They're into turn 10.
And Alan Turpin's just had his fastest lap of the day. Still a tenth of a second slower than the fastest lap for Seidel, but you can tell that Alan is really pushing it hard. And they are running basically nose-to-tail, the three of them. First bobble here is going to be first loser. Seidel's
no
right up on him.
From the starter, they're still going, and Seidel trying to get alongside, going into one.
That's an outside move, which is really... Oh, he made the move. Oh, my goodness. Fritz Seidel did an outside pass on Thomas Gruber, going into turn one. Turpin comes through behind him
through.
And basically moves Thomas over, almost off the track. That really unsettled Gruber. He got very unsettled when Seidel took him on the outside of the Andretti hairpin.
So Gruber went from first to third. As first, Seidel made the move. He went around the outside, driver's right, and he went into the corner much deeper than Gruber. Gruber let him go. He probably figured there's no way he's going to make this corner. He's going to spin out. But Seidel was able to keep it together and complete the pass. And on top of that, Turpins followed him through as well in the 40 car.
And the way Seidel's brakes had not been behaving very well with his driver's front locking up, it was surprising to see him able to make that heavy, heavy braking pass. Okay, they're coming onto the pit straight now. Fritz Seidel passing a lap car going up. Alan Turpins struggling to pick up behind him. And Thomas Gruber has fallen back substantially at this point.
Yeah, and they got the wall laps. Alan Seidel goes off in turn one almost. He got it sideways, went in too deep, braked real hard. The car fishtailed back and forth, and Turpins was able to pass him for the lead on this, the final lap. But Seidel's not done. He wants that lead position back. He just got it on the last lap. Went into one too hot. The car fishtailed. He was able to save it. But while he was doing that, Turpins got by him.
Tried to replicate the really heavy braking that he did last lap. Tried it this lap, and the car just wouldn't stick. Braking wouldn't hold, and Allen picked him off, so Turpins is our race leader as they head up the hill.
This is the last lap, and the checkered flag will fall to the first of these cars that crosses the start-finish line. Right now, it looks like it's going to be Alan Turpins in car number 40. If he can maintain the lead through a couple of more corners, he is going to be your race winner.
Up at this point, it is virtually locked. And Turpins and Fritz Seidel pull onto the pit straight, headed up for start finish. Checker flag is in hand, and the checker's out. Alan Turpins wins. Seidel finishes second. Third spot's going to go to Gruber, and Long trying to pick him off, just can't get it done. Gruber finishes in third spot. Patrick Long in fourth. In car number 68, Long had closed up on Gruber and almost picked him off at the start-finish line. The number 92 car of Reichel finishes in fifth.
Yeah, we'd have to opine that something happened to Thomas Gruber's car because he was running so strong the first three quarters of this race, and then fell back pretty substantially. And to have Patrick and the little two-liter catch up to him right here at the end would indicate that Gruber had probably some minor little mechanical malfunction that was holding him back. Okay, let's ride down the top 10 cars for you in this race. As you well know, Alan Turpins wins with a fast lap of 144.8. Fritz Seidel finishes second with a top time of 144.8, car number 61. Car 158, Thomas Gruber, finishes third with a time of 144.85. Patrick Long finishes a very close fourth, very close to third, in the 68 white 911 2-liter, running a 145.65. Congratulations to Alan Turpins on a very strong drive and some very opportunistic heads-up driving. Congratulations to Seidel for finishing second, giving us a lot of thrills as he and Gruber and Turpins mixed it up through the second half of the race. And, of course, then in the first half of that race, Patrick Long was totally in the mix until we had that long yellow. And then, for some reason, the 68 car just couldn't quite keep the pace with the top three cars. Overall, it was a terrific race
a lot of lead changes, very good driving, vehicle dynamics changing over time as the cars heated up, the track got slick. So made for very exciting racing. Thank you, guys.